Welcome to round three. We'll be on the play again. And it hasn't been going well so far. We've had some really good hands, but we just couldn't beat the Mardu. It's definitely not a favorable matchup, so it's not too surprising there. Hope that we can play against Marvel and Blue Red, because those are the good matchups. We'll keep this hand. We'll scry that on bottom because we don't have artifacts. And if we don't have if we don't find an artifact, this might prove a little bit hard because we have Spire Industry and Hub with no energy. Because we'll play to turn one Ghoulcraft. Shambling Event, so this is not any of the decks I stated. At least we got some mana. Although we won't be able to cast Spellgiller. Alright, we got something. And Zombie is our worst matchup. At least we'll get to try our sideboard plan. Three. I did not cycle cast out in a turn because I really wanted to draw land and cast out this Diagraph Colossus, but now that I drew a land, I'm actually thinking that maybe I want to just play Gideon. I'm putting him on a back foot pretty hard. On the other hand, he can easily kill the Gideon with just any creature by just stacking for four. I could Spellcore, I could cast out the Colossus. If I play Gideon and make a guy, he attacks my Gideon, plays a zombie, I cast out the untapped zombie. An attack for 8 is down to 2, but then he has a gigantic board that I probably can't beat. Or maybe I could beat with the Spell Queller. But he has a Shambling Event. So, yeah, this is kind of a long shot. I need him to, like, not have an instant speed thing that kills Spellqueller in three turns from now. So I go Gideon, make a guy, he kills it. Following turn, I cast out the untapped guy that he played. I attack for 8, he's down to 2 life. He has 5 mana. I guess the only thing he could really have is push, but he has no way to revolt it. Yeah, I'll take that line. It's super long shot, but I think there's like nothing that actually kills the spell card when he's on 2. There's Anguish in Making, but it's not gonna work because he's gonna be at 2 life. So I'm gonna take that line. That's like basically playing 3. I need him to not have 2/2 drops, I guess, is the issue here. Or not have Wayward Servant, but I guess he would have played Wayward Servant if he had it to gain life instead of Binding Mummy. Alright, I guess Cryptbreaker is sort of works, because he can pair that with another zombie. I guess it could be Dark Salvation. Okay, my line was terrible. Dark Salvation also wrecks me, because I don't get to attack for as much. Alright, my line was really bad. I should have cast out the Diagraph Colossus. Alright, now he only played Cryptbreaker, but he could still easily have... push. Which would make this gas out play pretty bad, but if he's trading here, that's like fine for me, so... I'll start by attacking. If he's chumping with the Cribbreaker, I meant. Alright, I guess that was it. Alright, let's see if this sideboard plan works out. So this, my board out, tool crafts for sure, Art of Kirin's. So the reason I keep a few scroungers is because I want to be able to cruise Kai Sovereign. It doesn't die to Fumigate. It's just a resilient threat that I want to keep in my deck, basically. So, here, here. Let's get the curve. So, it looks like... And Spellcaller is not that great. This usually just gives him a target for Dark Salvation. And it doesn't hit the key spells if often enough. Rebuke is nice because it kills Dark. It gets Dark Salvation in Liliana's Mastery. And the last card to board out, especially in the draw, is going to be Gideon. I don't think Gassed Out is great, but I think in our deck that wants to hit five lands, cycling is actually a reasonable thing to do to hit our land drops. Alright, well, this is the kind of hand we're going to keep. Like, I would never keep this hand in, obviously, in, like, game ones, but Fumigate is a plan, and I'm going to accomplish it. Mimic. So, as long as he doesn't draw a bunch of cards with Cribbreaker, my Fumigate plan's gonna work, so I'm just gonna deck and stone this right away. Next turn I get to play Thraven Inspector and hold Metallic Rebuke. I'll probably chump here. I really wanted to Dark Salvation it and get in for more later. I kind of telegraphed the Fumigate, but it is what it is. Crit Breaker. Or Metallic Rebuke. Hopefully, next turn he casts Liliana's Mastery. Click it in. If he plays Liliana's Mastery, he does kill my Gideon, though, so... Oh, okay, had to push, too. Maybe I should have kept that Gideon, but I didn't like that it was telegraphing so easily. Do I play... I'll start with... that. Crack Clue. Play that. And, alright. No Mastery? Is he playing around it? I guess I'll fire to Fumigate anyway. Kai Sovereign would be nice. Gideon, maybe? Kai Sovereign. I'll take it. Well, he just conceded, so I think my opponent is a little bit frustrated. Maybe he's flooding or something. But my hand was kind of gas from now on. So we'll take that win.